Demoralizing must that be for Sheamus, just when you get the upper hand. The young champ immediately takes it back and starts decimating you.
Slams him into the post. And Sheamus again is lined up out on the floor. Bron Breakker on the apron. He's not going to go from there. Over the announce desk. Just sending Sheamus sprawling onto the floor. Moments ago, as they came crashing across our announce desk, Intercontinental Championship, as Bron Breakker has his first title defense since regaining the title.
There's been nothing pretty about this one. It's been about two words, pace and power. And I'm not sure who's getting the best of it. Both men have to be hurting.
He's up on that apron again.
Bron Breakker cooking up something dastardly here as the Celtic Warrior is in a world of hurt.
He's climbing to the top rope from up high. Oh! High, oh my, Wade.
Oh my, what a horrible landing for Bron Breakker. Sheamus taken out in the process. Breakout throwing it all on the line here in pursuit of defense of this Intercontinental Championship.
The damage he is willing to do to his own body. Look at this.
Breakker almost landed bang on the top of his head. Amazing athleticism to tuck at the very last second.
He's taking it to a different level tonight with what we've seen.
There's a big smirk on his face after the volume of abuse that has been thrown his way by Sheamus.
This is the conversation that we had early on. He revels in this kind of style of welcoming the type of fight that Sheamus enjoys and wants to engage in. And he's elevating his game, is Bron Breakker.
Trust me, the entire locker room knows how tough and nasty Sheamus can be.
Sheamus back up on his feet, rallying back right hand after right hand. Slams the champ.
A little window for Sheamus to get some air back in these lungs. This audience willing the Celtic Warrior onto success. They know how much this championship means to him.
He said, I've been around for over 15 years. You've been around 15 minutes. Sheamus trying to take all that experience to Bron Breakker and claim the IC title. Ten beats lined up.
The champ is rocked. And the champ might be right to the picket here.
Can Sheamus take advantage? Can he close in on victory?
Taking Bron Breakker to territory he perhaps has not been to before.
Here's the cover to become the Intercontinental Champion finally. Oh, no. Just getting the shoulder up at the last moment is Breakker.
And it's incredibly demoralizing for someone like Sheamus, who believed he had it won there, to see the youngster kicking out. This guy's tougher than I thought. What else do I have in the tank to put him away?
Looking for white noise instead. A counter by Breakker, but just not enough left in his tank at that moment.
Big swing by Sheamus, swinging for the fences, but Bron Breakker just had something cooked up.
The knees to the lower back, the cover to retain. And Sheamus able to find a way.
Just in that point in the matchup where the brain isn't working as well as you would like. If Bron had hooked a leg there, he could well have got the three count. You can't exactly fault him for not firing on all cylinders this deep into the matchup, however.
Big crowd here enjoying the 15th Intercontinental Championship match to take place in this calendar year. And you can hear Bron Breakker saying, it's over. He feels like he has taken control.
See how quickly Bron Breakker recovers from the abuse he receives. That's the astounding thing about Breakker.
Sheamus has him up high. both men have exhausted so much, emptying the tanks time and again to battle for this Intercontinental Championship.
Just championship timing from Bron Breakker on the kick out. Almost instinctively after a massive move from Sheamus.
Such appreciation for these two, the veteran and the young ascendant star.
Well, I'll tell you, it will mean nothing to Sheamus unless he can grab the gold tonight. He's not here for a participation medal. He wants real gold.
And you can see the mouths open as who has more left in the tank to get to the end here, to come out the victor.
Astounding, either of these men have anything left in the tank. What the hell?
Top rope Frankensteiner, Bron Breakker.
How do you do that fresh as a daisy?
That level of explosiveness.
And how do you do it after the beating Sheamus has put on you?
This deep into a championship match, he finds a way. Sheamus.
Kneecap to the dome.
And an opportunity to win it. Could he? No.
A full force spear going in the direction of the Celtic Warrior. Augmented. This kneecap to the dome on Bron Breakker. And as close a pin as you will ever see without it resulting in victory. Sheamus almost crestfallen.
2-point change from getting the final piece of his career puzzle. This crowd wants Bro. Instead, it's a spear.
Connecting deep into the gut of Sheamus.
How smart, though, for Sheamus to just find enough to roll out.
Was it smart or was it just good fortune for Sheamus? I don't know how much control Sheamus has on his body after that connection from a spear that has taken out literally everybody it is connected with. Either way, the matchup continues. Sheamus is
live
on in this matchup.
What? Ludwig Kaiser comes out of nowhere. Bron Breakker was in the midst of lining up a full throttle super spear, and Ludwig Kaiser clotheslines him and now is beating away on the Intercontinental Champion, and this match is interrupted and over.
Well, a classic match ruined by the intervention of Ludwig Kaiser. What was it Gunther said?
And now he's coming around the corner and delivers that right into the steel steps. The right-hand man, the associate to the